What's up, Circuit View fans? We're coming at you with another video. Today we're going to check out another awesome audio product from my friends over at Bluedio. We've got another Bluetooth speaker to check out from them today, but before we get into the box, we're going to head over to the website and check out a couple details. So you can find them over on Amazon, guys. The link will be down in the description for you, as always. But what we've got today here is, again, a Bluetooth speaker with a couple cool little features. So it is a 2.1 channel wireless Bluetooth speaker with a 59mm subwoofer built in with micro SD card functionality as well. So it's going to run you $80. It is available through Prime. Let's check out a couple of the photos here. So what we've got is a pretty interesting looking speaker. It's kind of got this Swiss cheese motif going on here. We've got a control scheme on the top that is very similar to the headphones that we checked out from them a few months ago. There's a little cutaway so you can kind of see what we got going on inside. There's a picture of the back. So a very nice looking product. What we get in the box is micro USB charging cable and an aux cable. So let's scroll down and on the website here and see what else we need to check out. So it uses the latest Bluetooth standards. And then it talks about some of the things that they took into account when they designed the speaker as well. So you can pause all that and read it for yourself. There's a couple tech specs for you as well. So again, head through the link down in the description, guys. This is going to run you about $80 over on Amazon. So let's check out the box here. So very nice retail packaging, like anything I'd expect to see at Best Buy or anything like that. So on the side here, we do list a couple of the features. It has an equalizer, integrated speakerphone. Again, you can place a micro SD card directly in the unit and play songs directly from there. You can use it wired if you prefer, and then the latest Bluetooth standard as well. On the side, there's some tech specs for you to check out. And then some of the features on the back here. So in the middle of the unit here, again, this is the complete control interface right here. So on the left, we've got volume down and skip track. On the opposite side, we've got volume up and again, skip track there. Mode button, so you can change between Bluetooth, micro SD, whatever you want to use. A multifunction button that enters pairing mode. Play and pause, answer and end phone calls, and redial as well. The microphone is located right around there, and then the bottom button here can change the equalizer. So that's all cool. Let's get right into the box here and check this thing out. Alright, so just flips open here. Very similar to the headphones that we checked out here. Same kind of packing materials and box setup. So right here, again, we've got the propaganda, various how-tos, everything like that. And then on the side here is the speaker itself. So let's get all this open, peel this out. So we've got the speaker right here. And then on the sides are your little cables there. And that's about it in the box. So we can put all that off to the side. Let's just check out the speaker. So before we turn it on here, we're just going to take a quick tour around and look at this thing. So again, I've got the all silver here. You can get it where this part is black as well. So on the front again, we've got kind of that Swiss cheese looking pattern. This is just a plastic cover on top of the speaker grill, but it gives it a different kind of look and feel. We can see both speakers on the outside there. We have a nice large subwoofer built into the bottom. On the back is just a basic speaker grill with a couple interfaces here for your micro SD card, micro USB charging port, and then the 3.5mm audio as well. And then again up top, this is your control scheme. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 buttons and then the one in the middle. So looking around the outside, it is pretty nice looking. I mean, for $80, I would expect a little bit better build quality, I think. This is all plastic here. The entire thing feels to be made of plastic, and I think for $80 I would like a little bit more metal. I mean, it does look and play the part, but again, it just has a little bit of a cheap feel. Now again, it looks nice, at least in person, and hopefully you have a pretty good idea looking through the video there. It does look nice, but I wish the materials were a little bit more premium. So let's go ahead and boot this thing up and check it out. Alright, and usually we have voice feedback here, so let's try to turn it on.
Power on. Bluetooth music.
Alright, so press and hold for power and then continue to hold for pairing. And we do have voice feedback there to let you know. So that's good. Let's try to get it paired up to the iPhone here.
The device is connected.
Alright, so we got it connected pretty easy, Bluetooth pairing. Let's go ahead and run through a couple genres of music. Now, again, same with the headphones, guys. The demo piece here is more just for illustrative purposes. Please do not try to judge the speaker through what you're hearing. through your phone or computer or something like that, because you're not going to have quite the same experience, but it'll give you somewhat of an idea, and then I'll try to supplement that with what I'm hearing live here. So let's go ahead and turn it on. We're going to run through a couple different genres of music to kind of hear what they sound like. Keep your mind on your riches, baby. Keep your mind on your riches. 911, it's an emergency. Y'all tried to murder me from hood to the birds. Every one of you niggas hurting me, shit. I'm legendary, nigga, scary and paralyzed. Nothing more I despise than a liar. Capped out, my mama told me when I was a thief. Such a vicious motherfucker, why these devils let me free? So many rumors, but I'm in. All right, guys, so at least listening to Pac here. So, I mean, the bass sounds okay for a Bluetooth speaker. But for some reason, it sounds like the treble's maybe too high. It just sounds kind of, it's hard to describe, but it just doesn't sound full. We're going to try to press the equalizer button and see if that helps. So guys, I didn't really hear the music change at all pressing the equalizer button there. So I don't know if that really does much, but we're going to change the genre here and see what some other kinds of music sound like. So what I have to tell you here, guys, is it's not very pleasant, at least listening to this kind of music. For some reason, some of the higher tones, like the cymbals and some of the vocals, they come out very harsh. It's kind of difficult to listen to, and it just wasn't very pleasant at all. Let's try something else here. So guys, got the Stevie Ray on here, and this doesn't sound all that bad. I mean, I went for kind of maybe a little bit of a softer kind of tune, because I wanted to see how that would perform, you know, something that doesn't have as much distortion as Pantera or something like that. And this sounds okay, but I think it might be easy to make this kind of music sound okay from a speaker. And again, on all three of these tracks, I've pressed the equalizer button, and I can't really hear anything different. So again, I'm not sure what that does, but whatever it does, it's not very noticeable. All right, let's try one more song here. Before I got to the door, oh no, somebody just bought a Charlie Patron. Hang on, I just might have to stay. Oh no, with the time y'all was and the clothes all long gone, I should be halfway home, but oh no. So here, guys, we've got some Chris Young playing, and this sounds pretty good again. So it is really going to depend on what kind of music you're listening to. Let's try the control scheme and see how that works. So in the middle, we should have play and pause. So that works fine. Let's try volume up. Volume down. Let's try skip track. Okay, so you press and hold, and then release to make it actually do the command, which I wasn't quite expecting. Usually you can just press and hold and wait for it to do it. But let's try back. So again, it doesn't work until you release, which is kind of weird. I wish you could just press and hold, and it would do it. But minor gripe there. Alright guys, so that's about it for the demo. So coming back for the verdict here, guys. You know, I just don't know. I've checked out some good stuff from Bluedio before, but I just don't know if they did it this time. So for $80, you know, I'm trying to look at it, and how I do my verdicts is, would I buy it or would I try to return it? You know, would I keep it if I had bought this? And for $80, guys, I don't think so, unfortunately. I think there are better options out there, some that we've checked out here on the channel. I just can't find enough positives to outweigh the negatives. Don't really care for this control scheme. This is the same as the headphones. It's almost as if they took the cup from the headphones and just stuck it on the top here. And when I checked those out, I didn't really care for this kind of clicky control scheme here. And there's no markings or anything to tell you which is which. You just kind of have to remember. Again, this is all plastic around everywhere. Again, this might be a really thin metal, I can't really tell, but it just doesn't have a very premium feel. Now, it does look pretty nice, especially, you know, from far away, if you had this sitting on the table or something like that, or outside. You know, it does look nice, but for $80, I kind of wish the materials were a little bit upgraded. So if the price here was about maybe $50, I would seriously consider it and maybe even call it a win at that price point. But at the $80 price point, I wonder if you could maybe do better. So, sorry guys, I think this one might be a pass for me. Now, Bluedio does make some very good stuff, so do check out the headphones and the other videos we've done for them. But for this particular model, I think you might want to wait for the next version. If you guys have any comments or questions, please do leave them down below. I try to answer every single one. Find me on social media so you can stay in touch, but most importantly, guys, hit that subscribe button so you do not miss any future videos. That's all I've got for you this time, guys. Slick Reviews, out.